Welcome to Young Hollywood.
What's up, everybody? Nikki Novak here for Young Hollywood with two members of the band, 311, Nick and Peanut. How are you guys?
Doing great. Thanks for coming out.
I can only speak for Nick. He's doing great. This is our cool studio. We've had it for like 10, 11 years now. Made like four albums here, including Universal Pulse, out July 19th.
Where does the name come from?
Well, our band is all about bringing people together through music. And, you know, when people feel beats and they start moving together, I mean, that's like such a unifying experience. And that's what our shows are like. And it's about the pulse of energy that runs through everybody. And that's kind of a nod to the kind of spiritual side of the unity of what 311 is about.
Well, so Sunset in July lyrics, what are they? What's the meaning? Where does that come from?
Well, on July, we're always on tour. You know, our tour might go June, July, or might go July, August, but July, that's the prime time for touring.
And when the sweet spot.
That's right.
Touring.
And when, you know, five nights a week as the sun's setting, we're going to be playing in some amphitheater and grooving. It was just, the title came first as a way to kind of capture that cool vibe of when we're playing. And then Peanut helped me out to write the chorus lyrics. And it's about us watching the fans and getting off on watching them react to our music, because it just takes people to a different place, and they see them just smiling, like so taken away. So it's kind of about that back and forth that we have with our fans.
Tell me about some of the other tracks on the album.
There's the last track on the album, Anna Ways to Go, is a great epic journey. On Essay's part,
it starts really trippy and mellow, and then it gets into this like rap rock section, and then the end is this like sort of otherworldly, like pounding hoedown kind of like dance.
The name of the band, 311, obviously you guys have been together for a long, long time, but there's a lot of rumors about how the name got started. I'm sure your fans know the answer to it, but there was something to do with Indecent Exposure. Was that one of you?
A good friend of mine, actually the first guitarist in the band, 311, got arrested while skinny dipping in a neighborhood pool, and the police code was Indecent Exposure on the ticket.
Is that in general across the country?
No, it's different. Different districts have different number associated codes for crimes. Look them up. Interesting read.
Good name for a band.
Yeah.
When Peanut suggested the name 311, I was like, I love it. And then he told me the story of where it came from. I was like, I still love it. You know, I just love the number.
Right.
How do you know a song is finished? I mean, when you're writing something, I'm sure you could feel like you could keep working on improving it. How do you know, okay, we've got it, this is it?
Man,
what's cool is it's never finished. The more you play them live, they change.
Yeah.
So even after they're recorded and there's this one version that most people are going to associate themselves with, there's also a different version every night that we play. So it never really changes. And that's a great thing. But that's a good question. Don't hear that enough. Hi, I'm Peanut.
And I'm Nick, and we're in 311. And thanks for coming and hanging out with us here at the Hive.